Good day. My name is Adrian Rijkens and I'm the CTO of Warp Industries, a company that creates VR trainings and creating a great platform that makes it accessible to all to create these trainings. So during this webcast, I would like to talk about this great guy, the Windows Mixed Reality Development Edition created with Acer. It's their newest virtual reality headset that they call mixed reality, which makes it a bit confusing, but I would say it's virtual reality. So during this talk, I will first talk a little bit about this headset, then I'll talk about how to set up your computer, and finally I also talk about how to build your first own project using the Unity game engine. So I really wanted to create this video because I missed this kind of video when setting it up myself. So I hope I can help you developers out there creating kind of your first experience for this headset. So first of all, let's talk about the headset itself. So it's really a development edition. I mean, I do think it looks kind of futuristic and you can have your own opinion about it, but it's kind of neat. It has got kind of this simple head strap, which you can use using these buttons to kind of make it tighter or less tight. And it actually has a tracker inside of it, which sees, like the other headsets, if you actually have got the headset on, which is always great to have and to know. And finally, I think this is of course the most important part and interesting part, is that this headset has got two cameras in the front, which actually track the space around you. And this allows the headset to know the six dimensions you're in. So it works a little bit like the HoloLens, and that makes it really different from the Vive and the Oculus Rift, where you actually need additional sensors next to the headset to really know where you are in the space. So that makes this device pretty unique. So that's talking about this device. Let's go to the first step in how to set up your computer. So I'm a Mac guy. I actually logged in to my Windows game computer using TeamViewer because I didn't have any microphones or webcams on my game computer. So I thought, let me just use it in this way. So first of all, let me just talk about setting up your computer. So in my case, since I'm really a Mac guy, I really had to update my computer. So let me just show you the specs of my computer. It's always nice to know the specs of my computer because I really want to stress, I'm showing to you how I got it to work, but maybe you've got some software or different things on your computer that might make it difficult for you to work. So it's always good to know what my specs are. So let's first go to the system. So of course you need Windows 10 to get this to work, the newest Microsoft 10. These are my specs. You can of course pause it to really see the specs. And if it comes to all the devices I have on my computer, well, as you can already see, once you plugged in the headset, it will be recognized, the Acer headset. And furthermore, if it comes to my graphics card, so I've got this Geforce GTX 980. So in the end, it's really important. That's kind of your first step to update kind of everything. So update your Microsoft 10 to the newest version. Make sure you got the newest drivers for your graphics cards. So just make sure, like basic updates, you've got that on there. So when you actually get this headset, I actually got these instructions on how to install the tool. However, I thought it was very confusing still. That's why I'm making this video. But here you get some updates, and I'll share this link with you underneath this video. So once you actually updated your computer, it's also good to install the Windows 10 Creators Update. Actually, it's necessary. Everything I talk here about is actually necessary to get it to work. And what you also will need to do after doing the updates is install the Windows Insider Preview. You have to actually have to sign up for that. And once you've signed up, you can actually, so sorry, I've got a Dutch computer, but if I would say like developer, I can go to these developer settings, and you've got here the Windows Insider program. And once you've got everything set up, your computer kind of totally in the newest updates, you can actually set up the Insider program for the computer. And which is what is very important here is, it's actually still loading, but what's very important here is that you have to put your computer on the fast build. So make sure you put it on the fast build so you get always the newest updates offered to your computer. And the first time you do this, it can take up to like 24 hours to get that Insider preview. So what does help is, I will also share this link. You can go to this link and then you can immediately get the newest build, so you don't have to wait for that if you set it up the first time. So basically, that's all you need to do. Of course, as a developer, you might know updating your computer can be quite a lengthy process. I mean, I've been at it like half a day to update the computer. In the end, I just, you know, had to figure out, you know, what to update, all these kind of things. But once you've got it all updated, something really cool will happen. And that's actually that let me just show you. You'll get the mixed reality portal, which I just attached here, which will be added to your computer. And once you actually start the mixed reality portal and you haven't got the Insider preview yet installed, it will ask for that again. So it will really not work if you haven't got the Insider previews installed. But once you've got everything set up and running, let me just show you what happens. Let me just put on, let me just click on this portal. Let's see, yes. So let me just put on the headset. So now it asks me to look to the left and to the right and to the ground. So now my portal, my mixed reality portal, which is virtual reality in my opinion, is being started. And there you go, you are there. And now you can start enjoying kind of the things Microsoft wants you to see if it comes to virtual reality. So that's really cool. So I got it started. Let me just show you how it looks if I've got it on my head. So here, so this is kind of me using this headset. And well, basically you can, you know, start playing around with it. But that's kind of the first part. I mean, as a developer, of course, you like to create things yourself. So let's get to the next part. And that's actually building something. So let me just close this down. So now let's talk about kind of building your first project using Unity. So of course, one of the big questions would be kind of what Unity am I using? Well, let me just show you that. As you see, it's Unity 2017.2.0b4, the personal edition in this case, because somehow my pro serial wouldn't work with Unity on this new platform. But okay, I mean, I'm just using this for testing purposes, so that's okay. So what I actually did, just to start off, is I really created this really basic project, just having these kind of four white blocks with a plane, to just test out if I could build this and see these blocks in my new headset. So what do you need to do to get this to work? Of course, you need to install this Unity Personal. You also need the newest Microsoft Visual Studio 2017. And one tip that I have is, actually, before installing this new version of Unity, make sure you've got like your old Visual Studio versions deinstalled. I actually had a build and run problem when I had the 2015 still on the computer. So just make sure you've got your newest version of the Visual Studio, that's the only version on your computer. That will save you some time, because I actually ended up Well, I ended up installing, deinstalling a lot of Unity projects. I actually, at some point, got this one to work. So this might save you some time, knowing that the B4 works good with Visual Studio 2017. So if it comes to setting up your project, so I've got the camera. I do believe that that you should put the camera to main camera. They always say that for the HoloLens. But in the end, I actually ended up running this project and it worked fine without setting it up as a main camera. So I'm not sure if that's really needed. If you go to the build settings, let's go through the settings. So what's important is to switch to the universal Windows platform. So the target device, any device, build type, D3D. SDK, well, that's the latest installed. So that would be kind of this one, the 16,232. Wow, there are version numbers. And just build and run it on a local machine. So you're not completely set up if you've got that. Actually, what you also need to do is in the XR settings, you have to select virtuality supported. Actually, once I had that, Vuforia was a standard add to the SDKs. And then also this crossbars there. So what I actually did was I got rid of that SDK because I don't want to use the Vuforia SDK. And also I got rid of this check mark. Also in the, let me just see, in the publishing settings, I also selected some capabilities. Actually, I will share the link, but you have some nice, I will actually also share the link of this Unity version. I bet you can find it, but it will do that. But also, you've got these links for development, which Microsoft has. What I did is I went to the build immersive apps part with the Unity development overview. And there I was reading about it. I still think it's quite confusing if they're talking about the HoloLens mixed reality or this VR headset, because it's kind of, they're talking about immersive reality, mixed reality, it's all kind of going through each other, which gets confusing. But on this page, I actually found these settings, these capabilities, and I will share these capabilities also underneath, but also the link to this web page. So once you've got that set up, actually you can just select build and run. It really takes a while to get your, well, on my computer at least, to get your project up and running. So again, I do stress to have some patience also, not to give up too quickly. Of course, if you're waiting for like more than like half an hour, it might take a little bit long, but I experienced like it took me like between like sometimes 5 and 10 minutes before the project would run, which was quite long. But still, I mean, this is a development edition, so let's not be too harsh on Microsoft about that. So yeah, so that's kind of the basics. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm really enthusiastic about Microsoft really getting into the virtuality space. I really think it's a unique tool to do a lot of things. We still need to explore a lot. For us at Warp Industries, it's really the device to train people. We're still really mobile focused, but we do see that this could be interesting if this would work on tablets, that people can play our trainings at any place at any time, just using tablets. So that's something that's of our interest. So just share below this video also your comments on this webcast, if you've got something to add or if you've got any kind of questions. You can also just send us an email. Just send an email to Adrian at Warp Industries if you've got any questions. And looking forward to also seeing all the stuff you're creating with these new headsets and also the virtuality items in general. Okay, good day. This was me, Adrian Reikens. Over and out.